Welcome back to K-Ratio's Week in Preview. I'm Kyle Littner, and I'm here today to provide actionable insight for the future, not recap the past. In this week's episode, the fourth and final quarter of a year for the record books is upon us, and it may have brought an earlier than usual start to the freight holiday season. We'll break down what that means for you this week, but first let's take a look at where the freight market currently stands. The National Outbound Tender Volume Index maintains its comfortable position in the mid-15,000s. A place it has called home for every non-holiday day since August 21st. While not a measure of absolute volume, the OTVI does track the number of load tenders, which bears more influence on spot rates than total tenders alone, as it captures loads as they move through routing guides. Regardless of any definition, the gap between 2020 in blue and the previous 2 years in green and orange is about as wide as they come. After a very brief pullback, national cancellations have moved right back into a 26% handle, the high for the year. Taking the inverse of this metric multiplied by the OTVI returns us to the accepted tender volume index, coming in at 11,412 compared to last year's 9,547, a year-over-year increase of 20%. Without even getting into any calculation of current truck supply or concentration of load volume, that is a massive growth in volumes. The kind of growth that destroys routing guides and jacks spot rates right back to the $2.93 as reported by Truckstop. All of this at a time when the industry is supposed to be catching its breath and preparing for the big holiday season push. If we take another look at the latest update to our new favorite chart of spot and contract rates as reported by DAT, we are given a number of items to work through. First, spot rates moved higher again from last week by another 4 cents, a substantial increase given the 60-plus billion in annual transportation data DAT provides. The shocking number here, however, is the 4-cent jump in contract rates from last week. Yes, I said contract. It appears shippers are renegotiating rates en masse, and this has kept the spread between spot and contract at 13 cents during a time when spot rates are still climbing. It is this second-order effect of a prolonged spot market rally, the rise in contract rates, that can and will cause rejections to remain high and apply continuous upward pressure on rates even if we see a pullback in volume. Remember, every time a 3PL books a load, regardless if it's spot or contract, it's done on the open market and it's done at spot market rates, effectively making it spot market business as it pertains to rates. With contract rates rising 39 cents in a little over 4 months, the competition to secure capacity across all loads extends to even those on lanes not originally underwater. Let's revisit an idea and a lane that we highlighted in early August. Spot rates for LA to Salt Lake City crossed over contract back in May and have plateaued above 2,500 like we predicted. With a baseline set at the average contract rate of nearly 1,800, we can see the profitable times of 2020 in green and the negative margin in red. At some point, all 3PLs with contract freight like this are forced to give back the business or ask their customers to reprice the lane. This type of lane and the fallout is common, though. This isn't the real problem for freight. Heavily trafficked lanes with tight margins like Chicago to Atlanta are the real problem. We've set the baseline here at the average contract rate, $17.50, and you can easily see that spot rates did not exceed that level until mid-August instead of May like the previous example. When a major lane like this gets into negative margin territory, the entire 3PL participant class is now in trouble. Even the ones with half a billion of fresh investment capital to burn through, or the upstart familial types with a sensitive social media presence. Sprinkle in anecdotal reports of holiday loads already coming online, and a preliminary Port of LA September volume number that beats August record amount, and you have a situation that will persist into at least 2021. What does this mean for freight this week? Carriers, we all know about LA. It's 8.3% of all national volume, but there's a volume monster on the East Coast as well. Harrisburg is now at 3.7%, equal to Atlanta, and with nearby Allentown at 2.1 and Elizabeth at 2.7, there's a lot of freight moving in the Northeast, and that's caused backhauls like Philly to Chicago to jump 20% year over year. Don't be afraid to head to the Northeast because you're still going to get paid coming out. Brokers, at this point, there is nowhere left to hide. You need to approach your customers to renegotiate your lanes, but do so with some data behind you. Don't just come at them with a flat COVID fee of X. Shippers, holiday season really has begun. And even if your freight is not seasonal, network capacity is. So you're going to need to get ahead of this. Either put some rates on file or run a mini bid, but don't let this holiday season ruin it for your customers and your transportation department. To stay up to date with everything freight, follow us on LinkedIn, or for more information on all of our products, including our award-winning freight intelligence platform, so your margins don't end up where they are today, check us out at k-ratio.com. Please stay safe, and thank you all for watching.